I do think there's more upside potential for stocks in the U.S. and globally. Tech and consumer discretionary have led the way thus far in 2018. Consumer discretionary, Amazon, looking on the tech side, Apple. And I think M&A may be the juggernaut that's going to spur even more upside potential in both areas, especially if you look a little deeper in terms of fintech, biotech as well, to expand the upside potential that we see.
So Eric, what do you think the market's been doing lately? Is it just a rest before the resurgence of the rally? Do you agree?
Well, I mean, again, the small cap sector is certainly not resting.
No, neither has the Nasdaq, more broadly. We had this big run up from, May 3rd to June 12th.
Right.
You're up 6% on the Dow, 6% on the S&P, almost 10% on the Nasdaq, right. And then a pause. So what happens now?
Well, I think the broader market will continue to pause because the trade issues are going to be out there. I think the immigration issues are going to be out there. You've got the Fed tightening. These are big picture issues that are going to put a lid on the overall market. But as you indicated, money's moving around into other sectors, so other sectors are performing.
So are you raising cash because you think the market's going to be flat, or are you just redirecting it to different parts of the market?
Yeah, so we've raised a little bit of cash, not dramatic, just a small amount. We're incrementalists, so we move slowly. But mainly we like to continue to focus on the small cap value stocks, and it's spreading into some of the consumer stocks on the small cap area, which are beginning to perform after lagging for a long time. So that's an area.
And why is that? Is that tax reform? Is that because they're protected from trade issues? What?
Both. Yeah. I mean, these are companies that paid 36% in taxes that are now paying 21% or less, and they don't have international business. So it's both of those.
Kevin, you like small caps? Is this the whole sort of domestic insulation from global tensions?
Yeah, I think you don't have that multinational risk that you do with some of the
large. At what point do you get concerned about valuation?
Not yet. I think about, the corporate tax cuts. I think about some of the sectors that are predominant in the small cap space. I think that's going to drive the market forward. I also think there's opportunities away from small cap. And I think the pullback we've seen in international markets, because a lot of the trade and tariff tantrum, if you will, has created a very attractive entry point. So I wouldn't be surprised to see developed markets in particular start to make a comeback.
All right, Eric, let's go some names because you want to do some stock picking for us today, too. Give me a few names that you like right now. And I would assume they're going to be in the small cap range, since that's what you like most?
Right. So we've had a couple of big winners recently, and so I'll point out BG Staffing is a company that's all domestic that provides temporary workers in multiple industries. Really good business, growing nicely. We've got...
Looking at some of your picks right there on the screen. Monmouth, Westwood Holdings, Douglas Dynamic. I mean, not stocks we talk about every day,
right.
But ones that you obviously think have some upside to go.
Right. Douglas Dynamics makes snow plows. So in Chicago in the winter, it's a great stock to own.
You're making a hometown call.
It's a hometown
call. From experience.
Yeah, we know we need those snow plows. And it's been a company that ever since they went public has raised their dividend every single year, made a couple of acquisitions. Just been a terrific holding for us.
Kevin, so... when do small caps get too expensive, to Melissa's question?
I mean, even if you look at it on a forward PE basis right now, it's still trading below its 10-year average. So we're mid caps. So I think we still have some more upside room to run there. The thing we have to also factor in is, does the Fed now move two additional times this year as opposed to one? And do they only move three times next year? At this pace, and the Fed did say just last week that now the economy is growing at a solid pace, that's a very constructive environment for small cap companies, and I do agree that that's an attractive area.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.